Hey, what's happening, everybody? This is Robert, the Leather Cowboy Muhammad with Premier Leather Crafters, again with another video. I had a customer that hit me up that wanted a custom leather bracelet or leather cuff from the West Coast. I'm here quite naturally. I mean, of course, I'm here in Alabama in the South, the dirty. But I thought it would be a prime opportunity to do this video to show you guys just what do you do when you have a customer that's out of your city, out of your state, or even over across the out of your country that wants a custom piece done for you. Now, here's the thing. Belts are easy. Purses are easy. All of those other pieces are easy. And here's the thing with doing a custom leather bracelet, cuff, gauntlet, whatever, just dealing with other body parts that's not normally sized. First thing, how does a customer or client size, you get their wrist size? Everybody's wrist is different. Everybody's forearms are different. I did pieces for guys that lift weights and who have massive forearms to even your smallest person with a teeny tiny wrist, a person that's only 100 pounds. So, but how do you get those customers to get you a true custom size where it'd be a good fit? Now, here's a simple way that I've come up with, because most people generally don't have a fabric tape measure in their home. You can ask and see if they have one, which makes it a lot easier. The measurements are the same, but most people generally have a ruler or something from their children, or they husband, or the husband himself might have some type of tape measure. So how do you get that person to measure themselves? Simple. You get a regular, you just tell them to tear off a strip of paper. Doesn't matter what paper it is. Most copy and paper, notebook papers are 8.5 by 11. So that's well far enough. You get them to tear a strip of paper off, and they're gonna wrap this around their wrist. Like such. And what I tell my customers is they don't have to wrap it tight. You know, if they do, you still can come up with a way to supplement, do that where it still fit. But you don't want a tight. I don't want to sell my customers a tight cuff. In the summer months, especially when it's hot or it starts to get warm, your body expands a little bit from the heat. And it's going to feel like a tourniquet on their wrist. So what I tell them to do is to take their index finger and slip that in between the paper and their wrist, like such. This is going to simulate for you crafters out there, or anybody who's interested, anybody who's trying to make their own bracelet, is going to simulate whatever type of fastener you're going to put, be it a buckle, snaps, button studs, whatever the case may be. This is what's going to simulate that to where it's going to be a comfortable fit, and you got at least a little bit of movement where it won't be tight on your wrist. And then I just tell them to hold that with the thumb, or just hold that some kind of way. I usually just hold it this way where you got free rein in your thumb, and you're just going to take your thumbnail where the end of that paper is and just crease it. Now, once you crease it, you can lay it back out flat, take your pen or pencil and mark that crease, and then you're going to follow that back up with your ruler or your tape measure. And mine came out to 7 3/4. The same as I told her to do out in out west while she was right there at work at a desk. I know it might have looked funny. Maybe the coworkers might have snickered a little bit, but hey, we got the job done. So when she told me, she said, hey, she said it's measuring 7.5, but I want it to be a little bit bigger, so make it an 8. I don't want it to fit tight. No. That would make it too big. If she did exactly what I told her to do over the phone, stick that index finger, put that index finger down in between there, that's big enough. You don't want to make it too big, because then your bracelet will be hanging down around here. She won't be happy, and you probably won't have a repeat customer. So I'm going to go with the 7.5, because that's the measurement that she said. She said it's measuring 7.5. Cool, fine. Now, I want to do something different. And this is the part that's really I want to talk to you about, talk to you, share with you guys, is most of your leather stores, they have these pre-kits that's made. And you can buy those, and they're fine. And they give you like 2-3 different sizes on there in those kits because they're pre-punched. But over the years, I've learned to get away from those kits. I don't want it to look store-bought. That's the thing about customization and customized work. It's not supposed to look store-bought. It's not. So, and a lot of crafters out there are doing the same thing. So, what I've done, and this is a piece that's leftover scrap, which I shared with you guys before in other videos. Leather crafters do not throw away anything. Don't throw your stuff away. This is the end that was cut or left over from another hide. You can see the odd, crazy looking shape. I keep this stuff for this particular reason. And what I'm doing here is I'm going to shake this up a little bit. It's going to be a little bit bigger than a bracelet because I really want to make this a customized piece. So I'm going to square this off a little bit. It's going to be a little bit bigger than my traditional size, but I think it's going to work. I believe it's going to work. And we're just going to take our strap-in cutter and set that. And we just want to make sure, I want to make sure that it's square. So I'm just going to trim this off. And you can see that little bit right there. That's the part I want to trim off to make it square. All right. And then, now this is, again, you guys that's out there, I want to make this, it's in this oblong shape. I cut these ends a little bit less than 45 degrees. This is going to, it's nothing better to a crafter than seeing your work in public and you can recognize right off the bat that's your work. Even though if the customer who may have never seen you before or, and I travel quite a lot, and there's nothing better than pulling up in another state or another city and you seeing your work off from everybody else's work. And this is what I do. And a lot of other crafters are doing the same thing. They're getting away from the traditional kit cuts. You can take your English strap-in cutter and cut it if you want to. Or you can take the square one and cut it. That's perfectly fine. You can do that. But you want your work to be different than everybody else's. So with that being said, I'm going to take my swivel knife and my guide. Let me wet this. We're going to miss the grain side and the flesh side. Now, I like misting both sides. A lot of crafters, and even you'll see a lot of other videos out there where they just tell you to wet the grain side. I like doing both sides. As I was taught, and when that moisture is on both sides, it makes your leather, the water starts to draw toward the center, where that's going to be crucial to when you start stamping. So I want my impressions to be really defined when I start stamping in these. Even my cuts, I want my cuts to be really defined. And I'm going to come in with my edge border, putting my border on there. Take your time, guys. As I always tell you, take your time. You don't want to oops on a uh-oh on a piece because then then that's when you got to throw it away. Well, no, you still might have to throw it away because this can very easily be turned into a snake skin cuff. It can easily be turned into a crocodile, ostrich, or whatever piece you want to use to cover that. But I want to stick with the original part of it. All right, I'm going to put a double border on this. And again, like I tell you guys, learn your tools. Know the tools that you're working with. And I'm going to set this just a little bit apart. Because the design that I have laid out is going to require a double line. And again, learn your tools. Learn how your tools work. Play around with different designs and print. And you don't have to take a lot of every work, every piece of work that you do. You can be just as creative with your stamping tools as you can with doing a whole bunch of carving work. You can be just as creative with stamping tools. That's why I tell you, buy your tools. Even when you go, if you're ordering tools, you can't play around with them to see what different things that you can come up with. But if you get a chance to visit those leather supply companies, they have a little section over there where you can take tools and play around with them to come up with different things. Now, I'm going to use two tools on this. Actually, yeah, I'm going to use two tools. I think I might do something different. Yeah, I think I'm going to add another piece just to give it a little texture and meat. Okay, now what we're going to do, as always, and with any piece, especially a cuff, you want to start at the center and tool your way out toward the ends. Reason behind that is that the part of this cuff that people are going to see first is the top side. And you can see where I put my double border line. And so when the customer actually wears this, they're not going to see the backside because the backside is of the wrist. They physically have to take it off or either turn their wrist over to show the continuation of the work. But you want to start in the center and work your way out on both sides so it's even all the way across the whole entire piece. So I'm going to come back with my measuring tape or my ruler, and I'm going to put this in the center. So 3.75, half of that would be, well, 3.5 will total to be 7. So we're going to go to 3.75, and I'm going to mark that. I'm glad I did mark that. I generally use a color pencil, and I try to find the lightest color pencil in there, because when I get ready to start staining this or dyeing it, I don't want that mark to show through my stain or my dye. Some crafters, you can use a pencil because you can erase it, and they do have other product that's out there, especially with Tandy has a nice little product that you can buy that'll remove any marks or blemishes that from a pencil or a pen or whatever like that, so it doesn't show through. But I'm going to take this, I mark my center line, or I mark my center mark, I made my center mark. I'm going to make a straight line all the way through that. Not deep into the leather, but just to put a mark there. You guys can see that? Okay. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to come back and put my fan to, well, I call this a fan. By the next time video that I do, I'm going to have a proper name for you guys. So, a vaner. There we go. And I'm going to put this down here and make sure that I line that up. And we're going to give it a good, nice whack. I don't know if you call that a vaner, now that I think about it. But I will look this up for you guys and give you a proper name. And so you won't, so when you get ready to purchase it, you'll know exactly what to ask for. That's why I show it to you, so you can see what it'll look like. I should have a catalog around here somewhere that I can tell you the proper name for it. Now, and you'll see that the ends are left because we have a little space on both ends. That's okay, because the bulk of the work is going to be all even. We're going to come back on the opposite side. Uh-oh. That was one of those uh-ohs. That's why you have to be very careful with the work that you do. Take your time, concentrate, and make sure that you put all your attention in on what you're doing. Now, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to I snapped this way along my borderline. Let me show you guys. I snapped this way along my borderline. And what I'm going to do is flip this tool over, and I'm going to go right on top of the other line. And I'm going to put this tool right there in the same existing hole as the other one. And give it a nice shape. Take your time, you guys, take your time. Line everything up before you get ready to commit to the stamp. Or to stamping it. Once you stamp it, you're married to it. So you want to just take your time and do that, and that's be perfectly fine. Make sure it's nice and rounded. Right there along that line. And you're just going to keep going all the way across. Putting this tool inside of the last mark that you've done, or the last stamp that you've done. And making sure you get a nice deep impression. Nice deep impression. Choke up on that hammer, that mallet a little bit too, where you can get a good even stamp. Sometimes I know a lot of younger crafters want to make that mistake of choking up on your mallet a little bit. Now give you, let the weight of the mallet work for you. And you will come up with this right here. See that? Nice. Even. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to come back with a cedar. Now, I know the name of this one. This is called a cedar. It's just this regular little oval one, small, round shape. And I'm going to put this cedar stamp right in the middle of those triangular shapes that I've done. Right on that borderline. And I'll show you guys what this is going to look like right after I get done with it. And then I'll show you what I have to do to cover up that because sometimes you can, when you get just a small minor you can come back with a backgrounding tool. And this is what I'm going to use here. A nice little matting tool. It's round on one end and flat on the other, which will come in perfect. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go use that rounded end right in the rounded portion of that fan. Give it a nice, good, even whack. Now, on these end point pieces, these end parts right here that didn't go all the way to the borderline, I'll show you a little trick here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take that same tool, but I'm going to, instead of leaving it flat to where it's going to go over my leather piece, I'm going to tilt this a little bit and finish that part off. That's what we're going to do. And you can tilt that on both ends. So it'll give you an impression all the way to the end, like it's a finished piece. Very finished. Just so I can complete that with the little cedar here and put that in there. And that will finish it off. You see that? Now, then we're going to come back. We're going to wet our leather just a little bit more. Just spray it. As I told you guys before, I like using the spray bottle. I can control my water better than a sponge. And we're just going to get us a nice whack to give it some texture. And once I get to my borderline, I'm going to turn this around to that flat side where it will texture or match up right with my borderline, so I don't go over the borderline. I love this tool, the way this tool does, because it just gives it a little bit more character and definition. A little bit more character and definition. Just to give it, not definition, but just give it a different look, texture look. Kind of like the popcorn on your ceiling, you know? Not necessary. You guys can leave it plain. But I really want to give it a different look. And you can see that. Just give it a different look. Now, down this middle, I'm going to fill this in because the middle is unstamped. So I'm going to fill that in with the same tool and just go crazy with it. And I'm gonna move this tool along the way. Give it a nice whack. And fill that in. So it's gonna look like such. And now my is completely covered up and you can't see it. Ah, that's the great part about backgrounding tools or matting tools. You can really feel it in. Oh man, and I just had another great idea. And sometimes you can change this up along the way. For those of you guys who out there who have the organizer and things like that, I have way too many tools for the organizer. So I'll be buying tools forever. And organizers, the little box ones. You can actually make those. Maybe I'll do another video about making your own tool organizer to where you can set your tools in there. But for the sake of this one, just a brain idea real quick popped into my head about making this. There we go. I'm going to use this one. Now, a lot of crafters generally... When you're doing flowers and things like that, you will use this tool here to make the fold in the flower, especially on Sheridan design, like into the petals here. Into the petals, you would use this tool here to give that nice indention in your petal. But I'm going to show you something else that you can use that for. And we're going to do this in no particular print or order. Just gonna go crazy with it. Give it a nice whacking. Just to give this piece some character and authenticity a little bit. No particular order. It doesn't have to be in any certain order or fashion or anything like that. But look at that. Check that out. Just no in particular order at all. Now what I'm going to do, I already have my center line. I'm going to get ready to, actually, I think what I need to do here is, and this is one thing I'm going to interject real quick. When you guys are especially doing tooling work, save your holes for last, especially on cuffs and belts and things, because I want the work to be a continuing flow, and I want my piece to remain not stretch. It's going to give a little bit when you're stamping, especially when you're stamping and tooling. It's going to give a little bit, but I don't want to pre-stamp my holes. And then as I get the tooling around that hole area, it's going to make that hole start to close or look odd shape. So I usually just wait to the end. But now, here we are. We're about to finish. And I'm going to take my edger. And I'm going to peel those ends off. And I told you guys again in another video, this is one of the most important pieces in my set. I could have left it square, but by being a female customer, and I round off both sides. And you can also take that, not even, once you just take that main corner off, just to make it more round, you can go right on top of that other line or that other edge and round it off. Not an aggressive edge, but just nice, smooth, flowing, and round. And this is because when I get ready to slick this, it's going to make it real nice and comfortable for her. Now, I hope this, guys, all that's left for me to do now is to stamp the name into it. But I hope that this has given you guys some ideas or just to be different. It's okay to be different. Dare to be different, you know? And you don't have to go with your traditional ends. Just leave it like this or do something else odd. Because when you fold this, now I'm going to put button studs on this. So it'll be an easy close. All she has to do is just push them over the buttons. Studs and close that. But there you have it, you guys. Nice, simple design with tools. Just, and we used our matting tool to give it a little texture. A cedar. I think it's just 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 tools and you come up with a nice leather bracelet. Thank you guys for chilling with me. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button below. And every time that I do a video, it'll send you an email, let you know, hey, come check out something. Hopefully, I can always save you guys some money and show you guys how to best utilize what you have to maximize your dollars out there. I'm Robert, the Leather Cowboy Muhammad with Premier Leather Crafters, right down here from the Dirty South. Peace, you guys.